Miner's rule is a linear damage accumulation model. It tries to predict the fatigue life of a part undergoing stress cycles made out of a certain material and see how long it will live. It calculates damage, and when the damage total equals one, failure occurs. A lot of times that would mean something like a crack appears in the material, creating the failure. To see how this works, you need at least two things. You need a load time history. So this would be stress versus time, and you can cycle count this and find how many alternating stress cycles are present in the time history. You then apply that to an SN curve for the material that your product is made out of. This is a very simplified SN curve where we have 0 to 10 cycles. Normally these materials would have things like millions of cycles, and that is a property of the material, and it tells you how many cycles it can withstand until a failure or a crack appears. And then we have a damage tally. So to see how this works in practice, let's look at this time history. Here we can see we have two cycles at a certain stress level. If we look at that stress over in the SN curve, we can see that it would normally take 6 cycles before this fails. So we have an accumulated damage now of 2 cycles out of 6 cycles, or 33% damage. So our part has not failed, which is good. So let's say we have some more cycles, 2 more cycles at a higher level. If we look at that stress level over in the SN curve, we can see that we have 4 cycles to failure normally. So now we have 2 cycles where we'd normally have a failure of 4. So we have 2 out of 4, or a damage of 0.5. We can add up the damage thus far, and we would find that the total is 0.83, and we'd be glad to know that there is no failure yet. All right, let's add another cycle. So here we have 3 cycles at this higher stress level, 3 out of 4. We look at our new tally here, we have 0.75 plus 0.33, and we would find that we have a total of 1.08, and guess what? Failure occurs, at least according to Miner's rule. In practice, we're talking about millions of cycles, and we're talking about a statistical function for the SN curve, but this at least helps give you an idea of how the Miner's rule works.